that can hit you. What, compared to Pichu, you can just swing and everything's fine. However, they have not done Roy versus Rob yet, right?
They have not, no. Okay. So this is going to be very interesting. If he does go Roy, because Roy is that rushdown disjoint character. He's got that sword, you know. Roy and Krom, definitely the two swordies that are more on the aggressive side. You know what I mean? Some of the other swordies, they're more like, oh, I'm going to zone you out, space out with my sword. But these guys just want to get in and neutral.
Yes, exactly. I love that. That's one thing I like about Roy and Krom. They're aggressive.
Yes, yes.
So
someone's going to get messed
up. Yeah, exactly. If they're going to be top tier at some point, like, because I don't know if either of them are right now. If they're going to be top tier, we're going to have a fun time watching sets in this game. But right now, this guy looking like he's about to zero to death. Boy.
Yeah, and I mean, these warriors from Rob, they're so quick, and with the jump squat buff as well to all the characters, you know, Rob just has, like, most of these heavies just have more, like, an easier time just throwing out these arrows, but off stage here with the Roy, and that snipe is gonna do it.
Ooh, that's it already. Good snipe coming up from Wadi, and this is one of the troublesome things. People say that Krom has, like, a bad recovery. I know Roy has a better recovery, but I feel like it's not that much better. One little mistake like that, second jump wasted, you're gone.
Yeah, Roy and Krom are both dead in that situation there, and it's just, it's so hard. Like you said, when that double jump gets sniped, what can you really do?
Not too much. But one thing that Boyd did tell me, that side B. Oh my God. What percent was that?
He confirmed that off of falling up air. He was able to falling up air, run to the left to make sure he was on the left side, got that side B, and that like obliterated him at like 100. And
yes,
Rob is heavy.
Yes, Rob is heavy. Exactly. And that's one thing we're talking about. That side B, if you get the sweet spot of the side B at the end on the last hit, it's actually stronger than Krom's. And Krom's already really good.
Yes.
So Roy, like, there's some things he has that are better than Krom. People don't realize it.
Yeah, for sure. And one thing about Roy is the big difference is that consistency on the sword. You know, he does have sour spots. He does have sweet spots. So Roy actually does have more confirms than Krom because he has those sour spot hits. But now we got Roy off stage, and there's the quarter. He has a double jump, the early up B.
That was a good choice. Good choice right there. Can he get the juggle? Oh. Whoa, is he trying to get the KO at 48%? I don't know, man. He did an F smash. All right. Oh, what's he going for? I'm always wondering what he's doing whenever he does that back off stage. Oh, no.
Oh, man. I'm surprised. Maybe an up or a forward smash. Maybe from Boyd could have done it. Maybe it was just too slow. Ooh, the charge. Not going to connect that up smash, though. The parry?
So you do play Boyd a lot, so you have a good idea. Oh, my God. That play style. What is that? He does a short hop side B beginning.
Yes.
Like, what's the point of doing the short hop with it instead of just side B-ing right away?
You can anti-air with it, and if you jump out of shield, it's the quickest way to side B out of shield because jump gets you out of shield.
Oh, okay. Well, right now, Wadi with the reach right now. That's like three or four reach in a row. However, that missed space on that back air. Gonna put him in a bad position. Let's see if Boyd can get the KO.
Ooh, the armor on the uppy, but you see how heavy Rob is. But that doesn't matter. The back air gonna close it out off stage.
Wow, only 49%. However, he's off the side. Is that actually it?
Are you dead?
Oh, okay, he lives. What? Again? What are these characters? What is this game?
Dude. Damn, Wadi with the run back, though. That was just obliteration off stage, and we talked about it time and time again. Krom and Roy, you're not going to have fun off stage. You're just not. It's so hard. Wadi just covered he confirmed it, and then he just covered the jump. He knew exactly when Boyd wanted to jump, and that's the main mix-up. And he was so close. Like, a directional air dodge mix-up wasn't a thing. He had to do it very, very early. So it's just, at that point, Wadi just knew exactly what Boyd wanted when he wanted it.
Exactly, that's true. He keeps stuffing out Boyd right now whenever he's trying to recover. That's the key thing. He did it like two times in a row. Right now, we need Boyd to be able to recover. I like Final Destination. It's a weird stage because it looks like it's really small. I don't know if it's actually truly really small. It just looks like it is. Feels like you can't run away. So this might be good for Boyd because he wants to stay up in Rob's face. However, he keeps getting ledge trapped so much right now.
Yeah, and that top is so troublesome. You know, all these setup characters, they do have that little buff when they are doing those ledge traps. It's like, oh, I got this covering an area. So it can be really hard to deal with for Boyd. But right now, and another thing I like about Final Destination 2 is a lot of the conversions from Roy are falling aerials. So now that there's no platforms to block his aerial approaches, now Boyd can be very aggressive no matter what point of the stage he's at.
Oh, I see, and that's why I picked Final Destination. It does not get away with or losing the combos. And I like that up air. That was like the spot of the up air, but it looked like he would have been able to combo to something else. Can he recover? Okay, it looks like he decides to ledge trap. What's going to happen? Oh my gosh.
The mash out wasn't quick enough, or it looked quick enough, but maybe Boyd just didn't realize he had to mash air dodge right after mash, so that is kind of pretty hard to do.
I see. Okay, Rob Master right here. Here we go. Let's see if Boyd can get that early KO that he got last time. 69%. Hey, if he could do just a little bit more percent, he might be able to get that side B off the side of the stage. However, Wadi taking complete control, it's actually making me feel like he might need to see that Pichu come out.
Yeah, it's so hard for, I just feel like Wadi with his raw future, the directional air dodge too, and Wadi actually giving the stand grab that four times, he's going to be able to take it out from Void here, but can he get back on stage is the question.
Oh my gosh, that was really good by Void delaying that upbeat so slightly, so he did not get hit by that down air. However, he's still getting ledge traps so hard. I feel like when the ledge traps come up, he's losing like 9 to 10 out of the possible conversions. And here we go, 124%, 0%.
Okay, he's going to get thrown off stage once again. Wadi, oh man, and Void just couldn't tap, Wadi still able to put up the pressure of the quarter, finding his mark. And again, these neutrals are so hard for Void to deal with. Just that disjointed hitbox with the flames. And then Wadi also converts off when Izzy hits it.
Yeah, and he's getting a lot of grabs right now on. Okay, I almost thought Void is going to go for like some zero to death right there. However, this character does not have that upbeat like, for example, Krom and Ike do have. So it would be a lot harder to get a zero to death. It's very risky to go for it.
Yeah, I feel like Void can be more consistent at times, but when you need that clutch, you know, kill at 30%, you don't got that option, and that's a pretty big deal.
It's a very big deal, and that gyro is going to mess things up for Void. He's going to have to play patient, and that was a very beautiful escape from him. However, that down smash is going to get a KO anyway. Wadi now up a stock and only at 60%.
Yeah, and like you said, Wadi just setting up the top in very intricate areas, and it's so hard for Void to get out of these situations, and when he finally finds an action, Wadi's already there with the attack, and right there, that down smash covered it, and now Wadi is racking up this extra percent.
Oh my gosh, I like that grab combo they did with the gyro. That gyro combo looking amazing. Wadi looking like he's in complete control right now, and I love that walk away that he did.
Oh,
being
yeah.
very patient, it's almost like he lives with a Roy main. Like, I don't know, he's Senpai, you play Roy, what's going on?
Yeah, and Wadi is just, he's such a neutral player too. It can be so hard to, and this should be the, oh, not the kill. He needed the hard hitbox there. Wadi able to get out of that range, and now he's off stage with great directional air dodge.
Oh my gosh, it's going to be strong punish. No strong punish coming out from Rob. And that side B, he did get the strong part of it, but that was from the left side of stage. He's not going to KO. And I like how Wadi's playing it really safe, knowing that Roy could jump off stage and get one strong pair.
Oh, and there's the YOLO up B, but the up smash to punish Wadi with the two stock. And I don't know if we're going to see the Roy stay out here for Void. It's a tough one. I mean, it's just Wadi is nullifying all the pressure, and Void, like we said, you know, Roy, Krom, these are all characters that want to get in, get their damage, be aggressive. And Wadi is just shutting that out. Void's not able to get in and get these combo starts.
However, is he going to decide to say Roy? Is he going to play another character? Remember, this tournament, ooh, are we seeing the Wolf? I want to see the Wolf. Everybody's playing Wolf right now. It's like everybody's on the Wolf train. Here's the thing.
Flavor
that Void told me. Void, I'm probably not supposed to say this, but he said, the thing about Wolf is really, really good. However, people who... I'm sorry.
No, you can say it, dog.
All right, people who aren't at the really high level of understanding the game might not understand how, like, near broken Wolf is. So they're just like, wow, cool, this character that's not that good is winning. No, this character, look at Zach Ray. He did not move any beat light. He didn't press a button, all right? He pressed like half the buttons that you would normally press. However, this Wolf right now getting kind of smacked a little bit.
Getting the sauce.
Yeah, getting the sauce a little bit. Getting the heater right now. I feel like Rob can't, you know, produce sauce, but like heat, possibly.
There's the side to take him off stage. The snipe, I believe that was a double jump. Boy, using the early up being the down smash is going to take the sauce.
Hit him with the Google Now combo. Amazing. That's actually the down smash, correct?
Yes.
All right, is he going to go off stage? No.
Oh, yeah, Wadi going to use that up there. Oh, but what? Down smash. That move is DLC. I've been saying it for a long, long time. Down smash kills people at like 40%. Got that tipper hitbox. Can hit people way below the ledge. It is a nasty move.
That KO's so early, but fantastic stuff by Void. He needs to get one of those down smashes again, because right now, and did you see that? He stuffed out the side B, and Wadi immediately spammed another side B like, I don't care. Like, your attacks at this low percent are not going to hit me enough or give enough hit stun to make me stop from doing another side B.
Yeah. Oh, there's an air going to pick up the top as well, but Wadi ready for that. Going to get the up smash. No, Void with the mash and the buffer air dodge as well. There's a side B catch the high, and it takes out the stock.
Yeah, she randomly can see you use a jump and be able to catch that and KO at 100%. Good stuff by Wadi for catching that consistently. He's looking like he's about to potentially 3-0 Void on his winner's side, looking to fight MKLeo on the finals. Remember, MKLeo's been going Wolf, saying, I'm going to go Wolf until somebody proves to me that they can beat my Wolf and make me switch to a better character. However, Wadi doing fantastic against Wolf so far.
Yep, doing a really good job. So on two stocks here, Void still needs to try and find this stock, and can he get it? The down smashes are not hitting. And man, Wadi is just doing such a good job of holding on this stock. It is, can be really hard to hit this man.
Yeah, there's something about playing Wadi. This guy, oh my gosh, man. He got that sneak side back air. That's going to be a KO quick. Yeah. That was a jump air dodge upwards. However, with the way that Wolf recovers, like, you're not coming back. From that far away, you're done.
Yeah.
So good stuff to Wadi taking that 3-0 against Void. Void hopefully be able to bring it back in the loser's bracket.
Yeah, and I mean, very interesting character choices for sure. Maybe he thought the Roy could smother the Rob. Maybe he thought the... And I just feel like it's so weird because you do have an amazing projectile being laser, but I feel like Wadi as a player, he's just so good at like playing projectile characters and playing against projectiles characters. It can be troublesome to, you know, do a Wolf strategy with Blaster. Not to say that Boy was trying to do that, but it's just Wadi's so good against those types of characters. And really proficient at the edge guarding too. We saw all those snipes. We even see